Hello and welcome back to yet another video of Excel Finance Academy Hospitality Finance course. In the previous videos, we have learned about the fundamentals of revenue key drivers analysis and what are the various segments and type of hotels room revenue. In this video, we are going to cover some basics of how we are going to analyze the revenue and even the expenses. So this video is a general introduction to the type of analysis that we can do, not only the revenue but also the expenses. So the type of analysis, there are three type of analysis that normally are performed in the hospitality industry or in any industry. It's done step by step. So the first step is on the horizontal analysis, where we are comparing one period to another period. We will be looking at more details in the future in just a bit. Then the second type of analysis is vertical analysis. The third type of analysis is ratio analysis. What are the meanings of these three terms? We will be looking at it now. And then there are certain reports that we use for as an aid in the analysis. So the reports are market segmentation reports, how the bookings are generated, the booking source, who are the guests, nationality of them, how long is the guest being booking, how fast they are booking compared to in this year, last year, and then also the competitors. So this is the view, different reports that we use in, especially in the rooms revenue section. Now, what is the horizontal analysis? The horizontal analysis is comparing two different periods it means you need a comparative of P&L compared to the previous year, compared to the previous month, or comparing with the budget or other forecast. So, and it's a very, this is the simplest approach. It just shows the absolute change in dollars between the two periods and also the percentage. So but this is just only giving an indication of how the revenue has changed from compared to previous year or compared to the budget. It doesn't give you a more analysis yet. So the second stage, what we do is the vertical analysis. How much it's significant, because the variance can be in percentage, can be very high, in volume can be very low, but how does it impact the overall revenue if, let's say, we are talking about the segmentation. So it's all vertical analysis is referred to as a common size analysis, where we assume the total revenue or total expenses as a 100% percentage. And then we compare the individual revenue percentage to that total revenues to see what are the components or what is the portion of individual segment to the total revenue, so that we can understand the significance of this. We will be looking at in more details when we are looking at an example in the next video. So expenses are also analyzed with reference to the total revenue, but however it's not called vertical analysis. In that case, it calls a ratio analysis. So the ratio analysis is it assists in measuring the effectiveness of how business is being operated by the property. So it compares the operational metrics and also the financial metrics together. For example, mix of sales mix, for example, average room rate, for example, revenue per available room, for example, occupancy percentage, even though it's not written here. And then for other departments is also considered, is also includes food and beverage check, food cost percentage, beverage cost percentage, labor cost percentage, revenue per seat. For other department, it can do number of guests per occupied room, or average covers per occupied room, and so forth. We will be looking at in all the possible matrices in our real examples. So the ratio, but any kind of ratio analysis or the vertical analysis, horizontal analysis, there are certain things that we need to remember. First thing is, they don't resolve any problem. They are just indicate what can be the problem. They use historical data, and then there is no rule of thumbs to interpret the ratio or the results. However, you must also remember that when you are comparing two different results, you must compare them from the related number, you must compare them to a standard, and most useful when you are comparing them to a standard or compared to somebody else. And also the comparing the businesses, when you are comparing the businesses, it has to be common size, it has to be in the same operating environment and same risk environment, because the different operating environments pose different challenges and different expenses and revenue opportunities. In the next video, we will be looking at a real example of how we can do the vertical and horizontal analysis. Thank you very much.